Top 10 things to do when going to the club. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's your boy Renan Esteem, and today I will be giving you my top 10 things to do when you're getting ready to get your party on. Because if you want to have a summer to remember, you better be ready for everything. Now if you're new to this channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so you never miss a video. And now that we have that out of the way, let's start with number 10. You'll need a crazy wingman, just in case. When you go out to the club, you're going into an unknown environment. And pure math will tell you that a packed club will have at least 3 psychopaths. Those are the people that you never see dancing. The people with their arms crossed. The people that seem to be having the worst time, but for some reason they stay. And if you're going to hit a club up, there's a chance you might bump into them. And when you do, you better be prepared. Because just rubbing your shoulder on one of them is grounds for fighting. So what you need to do is bring the craziest friend you have along. I'm talking about the hothead of the crew. The guy who only needs to make one phone call to gather up the troops. Because crazy recognize crazy. So if they see you rolling around with somebody who has no damn sense, there's a good chance they might leave you alone. And that brings us to number 9. Bring extra money for the friend that can't get in. Now this person is sneaky. As you're all getting ready to go out, you're going to ask everybody if they have their wallet or their purse. Everyone will say yes, except this sneaky person. You will drive to the club, hop out and get in line. And as soon as you come close to the door, he's going to whisper in your ear, "Y'all boys got me? Because I ain't know they were charging to get in." But you being a good friend will still want your friend to join you. So the extra 20 in your pocket will grant him access. But you have to remember, he owes you. When you need something done while you're inside that club, it's his job to make it happen. As soon as he accepted that money, he became your employee. And he's going to have to earn every dollar. And don't buy him no drinks because you don't pay overtime. And now let's go to number 8. Leave the shy friend home. If you have a friend who's antisocial, stop dragging them out. You feel like you're doing them a favor, but to them it's torture. Plus, when you go out, it's all about the vibe. Because remember, you feed off the energy of the team. If everyone is high energy, then you will be high energy. So having a member of the Addams family with you is not smart. And keep in mind, they will never agree with any of your plans. If you want to jump club to club, they will always say it's a bad idea. If you want to take the party to somebody's house you just met, they will always let you know that it's not safe. And if you want to make it a night that nobody will ever forget, just know that they will never be in the picture. So if you have an emo or shy person, just stop bringing them along. Just leave them at home with your movie collection. And now let's get to number 7. Don't drive. If there's one thing I'd like you to avoid doing, it's driving. Most of the time when going to a club, it's in downtown. And driving through a busy city is a vibe killer. You have to deal with other people squeezing into your lane, driving slow on the highway, and constantly cutting you off because they lost. Plus, when it comes to parking, you're most likely going to have to pay. And they show no mercy when it comes to club parking. Depending on where you go, they have a flat rate. You came to dance and they want the whole bag. Even the parking lot looks sketchy. And I'm pretty sure the weird guy who waved you into the parking spot is gonna break into your car later. And that brings us to number 6. Stay away from VIP, because the VIP section is not for everyone. And to be honest, depending on who you're with, it might not even be fun. The first thing you have to decide is, do you have VIP money? Because buying a bottle is like paying a car note. They try to make you feel special about it, but it's not. Just because you got some sparklers attached to the bottle does not mean you could charge me $800. Now, some people would argue that you're paying for the spot and not the drinks. But what's the point of having the spot when the party is jumping on the dance floor? It's like seeing a giant party in your living room, but you can only watch from a cracked door in the bathroom. I mean, you can always send your boys to go grab people, but realize that only a certain kind of people are gonna show up, and that might not be in your best interest. And I guess that rolls us into number 5. Don't let a pretty face fool you into buying stuff. I don't know what it is about clubs and the little kiosk at the mall, but they have some of the prettiest people. But just like the girls in the kiosk that want to rub some overpriced cream on you, the club girls are looking for a come up. They might seem sweet and innocent, but they're full-time finessers. You try to get a dance and they demand that you buy them a drink. As soon as you agree, they ask, "What about my friend?" And if you let that pretty face fool you, that could be $100 down the drain. Because trust me, nothing will come out of it. She is going to take full advantage of your bank account. And as soon as you turn your head for a second, she's going to dive into the crowd, never to be seen again. And if you do manage to find her somehow, she's going to treat you like a stalker. And now number 4, wear your most comfortable shoes, not your favorite. People think putting on the best clothes will attract everyone, but that's not how it works. And I guarantee everyone here has a favorite pair of shoes. And logical thinking would say that you should wear it if you're going out. And I'm going to tell you straight up, if you love them, leave them home, because they will get stepped on and ruined. The club is no place for some goody two shoes. You need to bring the roughest pair of boots with you, or your most brutal dress shoes. And that brings us to number three. Don't propose, just get her number. You people be falling in love out here. You start talking to a pretty face, and just because it's going well, you think you're in a relationship. You start planning a family with this person. You start asking her about her ring size. But to keep it real with you, she might not even answer your text messages the next morning. So please play it cool. Don't be trying to set up no date, just get her number. And if she answers the next day, then you might really have something on your hands. And now let's roll into number two. Never leave your squad in one club while you go to another. Jumping club to club without your team is a no-no. You never know who's looking to get you. You could have stepped on somebody's foot in the first club, and now they done followed you to club number two. Plus, if you meet somebody and you wanna go, who you gonna tell? When going to the club, you're only as good as your supporting cast. So put the right team together and don't leave them behind. And now for number one, never bring someone you're trying to get with. You heard me right. Stop bringing sand to the beach. The club is full of many potentials. Why would you risk that by bringing somebody with you? And if your motive is to get with this person and you still haven't made a proper move, bringing her to the club might be your downfall. Because she might walk away for 1 second and bump into Tyrone. And once he's in her ear, she's a goner. And you're going home alone. So if your game is not airtight, keep her at your place and call it a night. Now hit subscribe.